having me here. The morning session was absolutely fantastic in terms of the regulators acknowledging the gaps in this space in terms of consumer awareness and consumer rights. Nutrition labels can be one way of getting there, right? So my colleague Rohit from Cuts will soon make a presentation where he'll show you what these consumer labels have looked like in countries like the US and Singapore have actually already implemented them. Some of the points that I think we should discuss is that what are the challenges in putting forth such labels? And one of the very first things that I want to start with saying is that actually it's a non-problem. Because all of the data that we're already talking about, right, the telecom providers are already reporting many of these parameters to TRAI in reports which are publicly accessible. Right? So there are already simple parameters on quality of service, which includes throughput, latency, availability, price points, customer service. All of these parameters are actually already being reported by the providers to TRAI. So this, for example, is what a sample report looks like, where you can see that we have all the providers listed, and then what sort of services they're providing for 2G, 3G, over CDMA, different things, right? So what's the minimum download speed that they're providing, what's the average speed that they're providing on different plans, across different services. And these are actually reported on a quarterly basis already to TRAI. So essentially, if we want to put out nutrition labels on the internet, all the information is already there. It's just about having the providers, whatever data they're already providing to TRAI, they also start providing it at the point of sale. Right? Now the additional effort which over this year we hope to accomplish is that how should this information be simplified so that it becomes easily accessible, easily understandable to the consumer. Because these reports, although they're publicly available on the website, but you and I don't know about it, right? In one of the previous projects we did with Cuts, we did a large survey of several consumers in three states, and awareness of TRAI is quite limited, as you can understand, right? So that's one of the first points that we want to make, that of course there's a lot of discussion which will unfold over the year in terms of how these labels should be structured, how should they be presented to consumers, what should be given at the point of sale. Maybe if somebody wants more details, they can go to the website, or there can be an app which can bring it out, but all the required ingredients are already there. It's just about making them available and accessible to the average consumer, which will also improve consumer education. So the next one that I wanted to move towards actually is that what more can we do? Because this to me seems like an easy problem. I mean, from a technology point of view, it's a non-problem because everything is already there. It's more about advocating that these labels should be adopted. But technically, what more can we do? So this is the part that I'll touch upon, that as of today, right, so over here what I've done is that who is the agency imposing accountability? Is it the regulator or is the consumer self-empowered? And can we actually bring down measurements at the user level if we can? Now, as of today, we know that the telecom providers are already providing these quarterly reports to TRAI, but we feel we can, with very little effort, we can actually move to a much greater level of consumer empowerment. So as an example, this is just very, very basic data analysis of the TRAI reports, right? There are these sort of trends which we can see, that Vodafone's